The Fuse Audio Labs VPRE31A is a 1960s germanium preamp emulation with a ballsy sound. The plugin is made to be driven hard and adds thickness and grit. So let's put it to the test. I'm Marlon and welcome to the White Noise Studio. Sometimes it can be a bit more difficult to hear what a preamp does. You have to hit the hardware and software right, and the same applies to the VPRE31A. With this bass, it happened when I inserted the DI-Fix plugin before it. With single notes, it can be a bit more difficult to hear. But when you use more complex audio material, like for instance when playing thirds on bass, you can hear the preamp working a bit better. Like this little bass part here. This is without. And this is with. Let me crank up the input. You hear the saturation kick in. This plugin has 5 controls for changing the behavior and sound of the preamp. You have the input gain, the phase switch, the impedance switch, which really can affect saturation and gain, the trim control, which is the output volume, and you can add noise if you like that. Other controls are a bypass switch, meter readout settings, user interface settings, general info, and this link button, which can link several instances of the plugin together. But only if your DAW supports that. If you use the preamp on the drum bus, you can really drive the plugin until it starts to clip and saturate. Of course, this is pretty much overdone now, but the drums sound really loud now. And when you look here, you'll see the loudness is all done by saturation and internal limiting in the plugin. The audio peaks are not increasing. This means you can use this preamp as a bus limiter, where it also will add saturation and aggressiveness while increasing the loudness. Your master bus limiter will thank you for that, so it can do its job more transparently. And this also works great on separate tracks like kick and snare. Here's the kick drum. Let's turn up the gain and it will sound like this. And we can do the same with snare. You can see the peak gets reduced quite a bit, but it still sounds great. The plugin can also sound great on guitars. Let me show you on these rhythm guitars. I will switch between on and bypass. You can hear it getting fuller and thicker with the VPRE enabled. And now let's use it on a distorted bass guitar. You can really hear that 80 to 120 Hz low end push. And the entire bass guitar is more even with these settings due to the saturation and limiting. You can find the link to the Fuse Audio Labs VPre 31A in the description below. Watch the video display on screen to learn more about another great mix improving plugin. Please remember to subscribe to this channel. Thank you for watching, and I will see you in the next one. Bye!